In the world of flight and aircraft, you have major companies that are always batting against each other. And despite their good and bad reputation, these companies provide service for billions around the world. And one, a new company, and one, on the other hand, has been around since before the First World War. With that, today we look at the differences between the two giants, known as Boeing and Airbus, and get our own opinions about these two companies. What's going on, everybody? Welcome to FTD Facts, the channel where I look at people, cultures, places, and yes, aircrafts from around the world. My name is Dave Wapple, and yeah, thanks for tuning in. Now, today on this video, yes, looking at Airbus and we're looking at Boeing. Now, this isn't necessarily because of what's going on in the media as of today. Basically, in our previous video where I looked at the Boeing 737, which was in regards to what's going on in the world, I was reading a lot about how Boeing and Airbus are kind of always in competition with each other. And therefore, I thought, is there really a big difference between these two companies? Well, I kind of want to find out, so I figured you guys would want to too. So let's just jump right into the facts. Now, before I get into it, if you guys are liking this video at any time, just hit that good old-fashioned like button. And of course, keep an eye out in the description box below and in the cards above for some cool playlists that you guys might want to check out because we got some really awesome stuff. So let's first look at the Papa Company, known as Boeing. At one point, this company was known as the Pacific Aero Product Company, starting way back in 1916. As a matter of fact, it started way before that in 1910 when William E. Boeing, who was the founder of the company, ended up buying a shipyard in Seattle and turned it into an aircraft plant. This happened back in 1910, and he started making aircraft out of that facility. The first plane that Boeing produced was the Boeing Model 2, which was a single-seat biplane. Originally, these planes were meant to be bought by the United States Navy, but they didn't really want them, so they actually went to a flying school in New Zealand. Quite odd. However, the first actual financial success for Boeing didn't come until after World War I was declared. At that point, the company was renamed to the Boeing Airplane Company, and during this time, they produced what was known as the Boeing Model 2. Now, these were also biplanes. As a matter of fact, they made 56 of the Model C versions of this aircraft. Interesting enough, this plane was also used for the very first ever in the entire world international mail service, as the Boeing Model 2 ended up carrying 60 letters from Vancouver, BC to Seattle, Washington. Of course, because Boeing has been around for a long time, it has broke a lot of records. As a matter of fact, it was the first airplane company to fly over Mount Rainier. What's really fascinating about Boeing is I always thought they would have started off transporting people around, but yes, as I said, it was started off with the mail. As a matter of fact, they specifically flew for the U.S. mail service. And ironically enough, it wasn't until July 27th, 1928 that the Boeing 80 was released, being the company's first dedicated passenger airplane. It was, of course, a really small aircraft compared to today's standards. They could only carry about 12 people on board. One weird part that really stuck out about the Boeing 80 is, unlike other aircrafts of its type from that era, this was a biplane, not like the others. And you may be wondering why. Well, back in the day, this meant for a more, you know, smooth flight and a better landing. So that is just the basic version. I mean, I can go into the history of it all even more, but you know what? I really want to look at, you know, Airbus right now. The company of Airbus may actually be very recent. It actually has its name dating back from the 1970s. This was from a consortium company known as Airbus Industry GIE. It was also a company of other companies that merged together. For example, in the year 2000, there was the introduction of the European Aeronautic Defense and Space Company. This company also owned Eurocopter SA and about 80% of the Airbus Industry GIE. However, the GIE eventually changed its name to Airbus SAS in 2001, and in 2006, the European Aeronautic Defense Space Company acquired the final 20% of the company, but by 2017, Airbus got its name that we now currently know it as. However, the ironic part is we've been referring to Airbus and Airbus type of aircrafts as Airbus for a long time now. This is because they just named their aircrafts Airbus to begin with. Of course, for some of you, you may be wondering, where does the company of Airbus originate from? Is it from one country, or what's the deal? Most people identify Airbus, yes, as originating from European origins. This is because the GIE was formed officially on December 18, 1970. This was a government initiative that was created specifically between the countries of Germany and the UK. And at one point, original shareholders of the country were 50-50 between Germany and France. It also should be mentioned that the Dutch were involved as well. In the early stages of the company, work was distributed different between these few countries. France and Germany had 36.5% of production. In the UK, which the company known as Hawker Siddeley, this company had 20% of production, while the Dutch company Fokker took 7%. However, as the years have progressed, this percentage has been changed around, so it's not really the same today. And because of the great technological achievements from all these different countries, one of the first aircrafts that came out of Airbus was absolutely revolutionary and could compete with Boeing. This aircraft was the Airbus A300, which was the world's first twin-aisled, twin-engine aircraft, having its first flight on October 28, 1972, and being introduced to the world on May 30, 1974 with Air France. This is where things really got really interesting between these two companies, because the Boeing had the 737 and that thing was a beast. It was very affordable, it was very good for safety, but then Airbus came out with the A300 and man, Boeing was not happy. For the Boeing 737, it was a very remarkable aircraft being introduced on February 10th, 1968. Now, whether or not you want to say which one is better, let's be perfectly honest, the Boeing 737 makes up 25% of the entire world's air fleet. It's quite popular. However, with that in mind, when it comes to the Airbus A320neo, currently there's approximately 6,000 of these on order, making it the fastest selling aircrafts as of 2018. Now let's look at some of the specific differences between these two companies. For the headquarters, Boeing is located in Chicago, Illinois, and they have approximately 153,027 employees as of 2018. For Airbus, it is located in Leiden, Holland, or the Netherlands, and currently they have an employee base of 129,442 as of 2017. Now, what's really interesting about both of these countries is they both do military aircraft and commercial aircraft. However, that being said, Boeing has a much longer history, so they've got a lot more military aircraft than Airbus does. Actually, one thing that I found really interesting about Airbus was the fact that it was one of the companies that provided replacement parts for the amazing Concorde jet. For Airbus, they have at least 10 different crafts that are available from the company that are on deliveries. As for Boeing, they have at least 15 different versions of aircraft that are available today. However, some of them are no longer produced. Keep in mind, I'm also not including any discontinued aircraft because there is quite a lot of them for Boeing especially, nor is that any other type of aircraft that is not listed as commercial. And I'm also not including any airplane that was made by the company known as Douglas, in which that company got absorbed into Boeing in 1997. Now, one really interesting thing about both of these companies is that since the 90s, these two companies have been known as a duopoly, having absolute control of air industries in America and almost worldwide. Another thing that both of these companies do contribute to is space programs. Boeing, of course, has a much longer history and a larger inventory, but Airbus has done that as well. For example, Boeing was actually one of the major contributors to the Apollo spacecraft missions, in which it designed the first stage section of the Saturn V rocket. As well, this company designed the lunar rover that the astronauts used to explore the surface. And of course, they've even made some contributions in the space shuttle. Along with that, they were also the first contractor for the International Space Station. They did things like make the steel struts for it. And to put the icing on the cake, they've also done satellites and rockets like the Delta rockets that take things into space. In which all of this comes under the Boeing Defense, Space, and Security Division. This also means that military aircraft falls under this division as well. Boeing has produced missiles, rockets, helicopters like the Apache. They've also made some of the most insane bombers in history, such as the B-17. There was also the B-29 and the famous B-52. And on top of that, they've also made jet fighters like the F-15 and the F-18. And they were involved with Lockheed to make the F-22 Raptor. Which, by the way, some of that technology went into the F-35. Now, for Airbus, its defense and space divisions are the second largest in the world next to Boeing. They've been involved in many different pieces of military aircraft, such as the Airbus A400M Atlas, to, of course, other different types of transports. But for fighters, they are most famously known for being the developer of the Typhoon Eurofighter, in which they worked with BAE and Alenia Aramachi. And for space, they are involved in many different rocket systems. However, for satellites, they just dominate. They have the largest amount of observational satellites that are up in the sky, meaning that they have over 50 of them that have been launched as of 2016. And last but not least, let's take a look at the dollar bills. Let's look at the revenue of these two companies. For Boeing, it has a revenue of $101.127 billion as of 2018, which means its net income comes in at $10.460 billion. The total assets of this company are quite large at $117.359 billion, with a total equity of $410 million. All of these numbers, of course, are in 2018. For Airbus, its revenue comes in US dollars at $75.406 billion USD, where their net income comes in at $3.244 billion USD. However, their assets are way through the roof, coming in at $125.510 billion USD, with an equity of $4.122 billion. Of course, for that was based off of 2017 numbers. So there you have it, guys. That is just some of the differences between these two companies. I want to know your thoughts on it. Which one are you more inclined to go to? Have you been on a plane and do you like Boeing airplanes or do you like Airbus airplanes? Which one's your favorite? For me, this is just the thing. I just like the fact that Boeing has a quite involved history and it's just been there since the beginning of flight in America. And guys, I'm not even American, so, that's got to say something. But other than that, guys, I'm Dave Wapple, and thanks for tuning in. Also, before you get out of here, at the end of this video, down in the description box below and up there in the cards, you guys can check out some of our really cool playlists. I've tailored it to military stuff that you guys might want to check out and enjoy. So other than that, we'll see you in the next one. Okay, bye. Okay, so here you go, guys. Here are those playlists that I was telling you about. Be sure to check them out. Hope you guys like our content. Feel free to leave a comment for future content. And of course, if it's your first time here, hit that subscribe and bell notification so you can stay in tune into the stuff we doing. All right, bye, guys.